yours, people.
I tell you, when you people send me these videos sometimes, it's just like, it's like you want me to do the dirty work because nobody else wants to stand up against these crazy horse women that do stupid things because they're afraid to be attacked. So you send it to me because you know I'll say something. So, equine helper. I have no idea if this woman, if this is her channel, if this is her name, if she's part of a group. I have no idea. I'm only evaluating her ignorance in this video. Okay?
I'm going to be shooting a video about giving Tucker here a makeover.
A makeover. Tucker. See Tucker's ears and the blankness in his eye? This is what I call the robot horses. They have no life. They are scared to move. They don't know the rules, and they just know when they're around humans that it's never fun, and they can't be a horse. I mean, I could see all over this horse's face. Poor horse is just so happy to be here.
So it's finally autumn, and Tucker's coat is starting to grow out. He's just really muddy and dirty. He hasn't had a bath in a while. I thought now would be a great time to give this pony a little makeover, make him look good.
Make him look good. He looked good when he had mud and he was a horse. You want to project what you think. How about I give you a makeover and I shave your eyebrows and I cut your hair into funny designs and I cut the bangs because I don't like it hanging here. How about I do that to you and see how you like it? Okay, I have to add this in because I know there's going to be people that are saying I'm hating on this girl. I do not want anybody to go harm or attack or bully or do anything to this girl. She's probably a nice girl. She doesn't know what she's doing. If she does know and she's still doing it, then she's kind of ignorant. But I don't know. I'm merely pointing out things that I see in the horse world, and I'm using this video as an example. So don't come here and try to make it into some hate video on this girl. I don't like what she's doing. I'm talking about behavior and lack of knowledge, okay? Try to keep focused on this is a learning event and not a hating event. See, because a horse can't communicate or fight back that you're changing his abilities to fight flies and insects and you trim his fur and he gets sunburned and you cut away his drip line hair so he's going to get wet and damp and it doesn't wash the rain away because you're trimming away all the stuff that nature put there for a reason. But you like it. And it's cute. And don't get me wrong, I love when horses are loved by girls that want to pamper them and take care of them. But when you start trimming and cutting off and whiskers and eyebrows and forelocks and manes and all this other crap, it's not good for the horse. And nobody wants to tell you women because they're afraid that you're all empowered and wonderful, that if you tell them, you'll be attacked and cancel culture and you'll be called a sexist and you'll be called not a woman and you don't understand, whatever.
The plans are, stupid. First, I'm going to give him a bath because he's disgustingly dirty. And then...
He's disgusting. Really? He's a horse. He's disgustingly
dirty. I want to
dirty.
Clip him. I don't want to do a full body clip, but maybe just a simple trace clip or something, just because we're going to be working a lot.
Chains, buckles, holding close, all signals when I tell you people don't have a clue.
Not more. I wanted to give you guys a before video of what Tucker looks like, and then we'll do an after now. So a little scraggly, a little scraggly.
He looks like a gorgeous horse to me. What's wrong with this horse? I mean, don't women tell us don't fat shame, don't judge, don't pick on me, don't bully me? Isn't it women that push all this acceptance crap? And then women in the horse world want to change a horse.
Little dirty, still cute, just has to get some beauty treatment. Let's show him the other side. And then here's the other side. So I just wanted to walk you through what, because there's a few things we have to do, getting clipped, getting their mane done, Tucker. So what I'm doing today is I'm just going to be giving him a bath just to get the dirt out of. I've never actually done a body clip on a horse before. I've clipped their forelock and their fetlock and stuff like that, but I've never done a body clip.
Great. I've never done it before, but I'm going to teach you other people how to do it and tell you why it's good because it makes a horse look better without any knowledge of how it affects the horse. For insect bites, no fur, sunburn. God, it's so
frustrating. I'm not going to do a full body clip. I may just... When we're riding and he's working a lot, way he's able to release some of the heat he may build up when we're
See, she's trying to make it sound all like she's smart and she's helping the horse. She already said it's for her own purpose because she thinks the horse doesn't look good now and I have to change it. I have to make it into something, my Barbie doll, because it makes me feel good, even if it damages the horse.
Working, but it's also a subtle clip to where he can still live out and I'm just going to blanket him and he can still be out.
Oh, you're going to blanket him. So you'll know when it's warm and cold and you'll be there 24/7. And if he gets too hot, you'll take the blanket off. And when he gets just cold enough, you'll put it on and you will do that. Oh, what happens if you have something else planned and your horse gets stuck wearing a blanket for 3 days or a week? Yeah, okay.
Side as much as he wants and he'll be comfortable.
Look, if you can't tell, I'm against trimming horses. Leave them natural. Quit trying to satisfy your own insecurities by projecting it on a horse.
So that's what I'm going for. Bucket and rag that I like to use. It's really dirty.
I've got no problem with bathing a horse once in a while. If they're sweaty, you're washing salt off. You know, if Buddy gets skunked, he smells like a skunk, I may use some shampoo. Most of the time I bathe my horses, I just hose them off. Then I let them out in pasture, I let them go roll in the dirt, which they always do, because they want that dirt and mud and sun protection and bug protection. They want to smell like the environment they're in, and they go roll. It's not personal, they're not being mean. I don't lock them up because I spent all this time cleaning them, and now I feel like if they get dirty, it's somehow a personal attack on me. Oh, she's giving him a drink. Oh. All right.
Tucker's not a fan of baths, but he did really good today.
I thought he did pretty good too. How does she know he's not a fan of baths? She's got a treat in her hand, so the horse is showing her some attention.
Very proud of him. He stood semi-quietly. Thank you, sir. Tomorrow to do that, just take over. And yesterday, Tucker got his bath. So what I'm going to do today is we're going to do some clipping. I also want to do right here in his chest. And that just lets him cool off more if we ride hard during the winter and he has his heavy winter coat.
So if he has his heavy winter coat, I'm going to trim it so he cools off more here. But I'm going to put a blanket on the back, but he's not going to have any hair here because it'll cool him off more. Well, that also means he'll get colder and freeze more. Stop messing with Mother Nature, all you freakazoids control freaks that think making your horse look like your Barbie doll is somehow good for the horse.
This will help him cool off a little bit more after our ride. Sheet on him or something, but there's a blanket on. So I don't have a good history of clipping. I've clipped quite a few times and I always seem to mess it up. So I'm a little nervous today.
I've clipped quite a few times and I usually mess it up. Well, I'm glad that you have a lot of experience on messing it up with a lot of horses. I'm sure the horses don't mind.
But the good news is hair always grows back. I'm going to start with the fat.
Oh, the good news is when I screw it up, it'll grow back. Why are you cutting it off in the first place? Because it's cool?
Fetlocks, because I think that's easy. Then once I feel comfortable, I'll go ahead and do my bib clip. Let's see how he reacts.
Let's see how he reacts. This is a very poor way to find out how your horse is going to react to clippers. If he's never heard of a clipper, he should have been introduced to it before it was turned on. Should have had it rubbed on him so he understands what it feels like before it's vibrating. Maybe turned it on a little bit farther away from him and walk closer so the noise isn't right next to his ear when you turn it on for the first time and he's looking over here not expecting it. Gee, I wonder what would cause this horse to spook.
To this. I know he's usually good, but he's a little antsy today.
He's usually good. I haven't had much success, but he's a little antsy. So it's his problem. Okay, I got it.
Oh, you're okay.
See the fearful? Did you see that flinch on that horse?
A little antsy today. Oh, you're okay. He's shaking.
He's shaking.
You're all right. Look. You're good?
Okay, she did do that good. I like the way that she put the back of her hand
you're
first.
All right. Look.
Instead of putting the clipper exactly. See, as she introduced it before, she should have rubbed the clipper on him before it went on. So the horse would know and see that she's reaching and rubbing something. Then when you add the noise, he's familiar with you reaching and adding something. It just seems so simple to break things down into simple steps, and people just stay ignore them.
You're good? Good boy. It's okay.
This horse is scared to death. It's not okay.
Okay, I think we're good. I'm gonna actually untie him.
Good move. She does another good job. So the people that are come here and cry, Rick, why are you picking on her? You're You're so mean to her. She did good on a couple things. This whole video is bad, but...
Just in case he does freak...
Even a blind squirrel finds a nut once in a while.
Doubt he's not gonna get all caught up in his rope. It's okay. It's okay.
So this fur line here that you see, and I know there'll be some people here saying it's not fur, it's hair, whatever. Look it up in the dictionary, all you smart people that don't, you know, are too stupid to be smart. This is what the rain would drip down, and it would keep it off the heel of the horse, so the hoof and the coronary band and the back of the hoof wouldn't get saturated with water, and water wouldn't stand there and make it soft. So this drip line is actually Mother Nature's way of creating a good flow, almost like a rain gutter for horses when they get wet. But, you know, it's going to look cuter when she's done, of course. Oh, we'll put cute music in it to make it sound really good. So this fur right here, this drip line that she's cutting off, the rain would come down here, it would drip, it would follow this pattern, and it would fall to the ground. Instead of going underneath here and getting wet and keeping this hoof moist and damp, it would keep it drier. She'll explain it that she's trimming it, and that's what it's going to do. This fur line here is a drip line to keep water off the coronary band, which you don't want to get wet and retain water. So the fur she's cutting off actually helps keep the water off the coronary band. She's cutting it off, so the coronary band will now get wet and stay damp. Perfect. But Rick, it looks so good, and she's trying to help the horse, and you're just being mean to... All right, whatever, you crazy people. Who really thinks that she thinks she's doing this for the horse? And who really thinks that she knows she's doing it because she likes to do it and makes her feel good?
And the reason I'm doing this, in the winter it gets really muddy. And if they have long fetlock hair and just long hair throughout here, it can actually hold like mud and moisture to their pasterns.
Yeah, because horses in the wild always have theirs trimmed. And we just have horses in the wild falling out from mud from their long hair. There's a little trim fairy in the wild that runs out and trims all the wild horses' fur to protect them. This is just projection and rationalization to justify so I feel good and smart. And other idiots who don't understand will think they're doing good. Nobody trims wild horses' hair, people. Hate to break it to you. I know somebody's going to come here and try to be smart. Well, what about hoof care, Rick? They don't get their horses trimmed in a while. You're right. They aren't trimmed. But they travel 25 miles a day in a while to find food. They walk over varied terrain, such as rocks and up and down hills and mountains, and they wear their hooves out because they're searching for food. And horses in the wild aren't fed high protein, good food, high alfalfa hay, fertilized hay, grain, sweets, carbohydrates, so their hooves don't grow as fast as they grow when we feed them all this high caloric food. So that's why they don't trim horses in the wild. Don't try to justify one thing to justify all your other bullcrap.
And that can cause like dew poisoning or just...
Yeah, poisoning.
So,
yeah, oh, you're saving
right
a horse.
Here, just
yeah, you know what? Put those trimmers on your fur because, see, sometimes this hair can get mud and it could block your vision and you could run into a wall. So I think we should, like, run around and just trim all the women's hair who have bangs to protect them. Yeah, it's that stupid.
To avoid that, and that way I can also see if they do have any kind of skin infection around. They look okay, you know, from a distance you can't really tell, so it worked out. What I'm going to be doing next is doing his bib clip. So between and then hard and felt, but they have that long fur, and so it's hard for them to cool off. By clipping this, I'm just giving...
So she's saying if they have long fur, it's hard for them to cool off. Really? Really? Do you have a problem cooling off? My guess is you're running around saying it's cold all the damn time. You got a long sleeve shirt on, the sun looks out there. I don't know what the temperature is. So if I trimmed your head to help you cool off, would that be okay? Because obviously you don't know that long hair isn't good and it prevents you from cooling off. I mean, it's just such ignorance.
An avenue where he can cool off from. Like, it'll be easy to have a neck clip him this way, adjust and also...
You can go watch her video. That's just, it's so BS.
The first streak doesn't look that good, but we can always clean it up.
Who thinks if the horse had a vote, he would say, yeah, I want you to trim me? Raise your hand if you think this horse, if he was asked and able to communicate, do you want me to trim you? Who thinks he would say, yeah? Well, that's just stupid. Of course he wouldn't.
All right, here we go. Good boy, no spooking. Yet, but I'm not awful. I've seen worse than this. So, first time doing. All right, so our clip is.
This is just so ignorant. I'm telling you, anyone that's clipping horses is an idiot. I don't care if it's a guy, a female, this girl's. I don't care if it's some Olympian medal winner with 500 gold stars. I don't care. It's ignorant to be out here trimming unless it's for medical reasons. You trim an area for stitches or something like that. That's the only time a horse should be trimmed.
Is done. And this throughout the winter just to keep the hair down as his coat continues to grow. So I'll have time to even it up next time I clip. So the next part of the makeover is I have to...
Makeover. You notice a few minutes ago it was to help him cool off and to keep him from getting poisoned from the mud. Now it's a makeover. Which one is it? Stupid.
Deal with Tucker's mane here. It's starting annoyed and I get him back and it'll just look like he's not going to have a mane. I'm just going to cut it so it can grow back.
Great. Great. I'll just cut off his mane. He'll get sunburned. He has no protection, no bugs. Bugs will land on his neck because he can't get there. So when he shakes, he won't have hair to chase the bugs away. Jesus. So
okay, so
stupid.
Before I complete the mane, see? Oh, Tucky boy. It's clearly separated from the rest of his mane, so I don't cut it off. His mane is. I think.
Oh, yeah, look how clean he looks. Oh, I wish somebody would give her a trim, give her a mohawk, and make her wear it around. And say, no, I really like it. I like when you have a mohawk. It'll help you cool better.
Because I know it will grow out and be cute. Doesn't care even what to think of basic grooming. So you can go check out my video down below if you want to learn more about grooming. But I do know even what to think about this right now.
Once you think about it, I'll tell you what I think. Pretty much what the horse thinks. It's unnecessary. It's stupid. You've messed up all his natural defenses that Mother Nature has given him, and now you've exposed him to bug bites, his sunburn, and unable to regulate his temperature. This girl probably doesn't even know what thermal regulation is because she's too busy doing her makeover. Look, I don't want people going and hating this girl. I don't want people beating her up. There's a lot of ignorance in the horse world. She doesn't know what she doesn't know. She may think she's doing a good job. To me, this is really ignorant, and nobody's told her that it's ignorant, and nobody said, why are you doing that to a horse? But you know what? I don't agree with it. I don't like it. It's my opinion. We'll end that there.